This video tutorial I will explain how to deploy Spring Boot RESTful Web Services in Amazon Cloud AWS EC2 instance. Till now what we have done is, we have deployed Spring Boot RESTful Web Services in our local machine. So we can access the APIs within that particular machine. And we cannot access outside of that machine. Publicly we cannot access the API because it is deployed in the local machine. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to start our own Linux server in Amazon Cloud. And in that Linux server, we are going to deploy Spring Boot RESTful Web Services. And the particular Linux server has a public address. So we can access the API anywhere from the world. We will see how to do that. Go to this website, aws.amazon.com. And click on sign in. First, what we have to do is, we have to create an account in this AWS website. And here you can see, create a new AWS account. Click on this. And here you have to provide the email address and AWS account name. Then you have to verify your email address. Then after that, it will ask some more additional information and the credit card details. Once you provided all the details, your account will be set up. I have already done all these things and I have my account. Now I am going to log in my account. I have successfully logged in to my AWS account. Here you can see services. Click on this. And here you can see all the services supported by AWS. Like compute. These are the different services. And database. These are the different services. Like that you can see different services. And to launch our own Linux server, we have to use EC2, which is nothing but Elastic Computing Cloud. Click on this. Next, what we have to do is, we have to launch the instance. Before click on launch the instance, what we have to do is, we have to select the zone. Here you can see the list of zones supported by AWS. And suppose your application is mostly used in Canada, then choose Canada so that the users from Canada will get better performance. The application will be get accessed all over the world, but Canada users will get better performance if we choose Canada as a zone. And if your application used by all over the world, then we can choose US East Virginia. Then click on launch instance. Step 1 is we have to choose AMI. AMI is nothing but Amazon machine image. And AMI is the template that contains software configuration. Like operating system, application server, and application. And these are required to launch your instance. And here you can see the list of AMI. And in that, some of them are free tier eligible. And here you can see the checkbox. Check on this. And here you can see all the free tier eligible AMI instances. Free tier meaning, suppose you are new customer to AWS, then this free usage tier allows you to launch and run micro instances for a year for free. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to select the first AMI, Amazon Linux 2 AMI. Click on select. Step 2 is we have to choose instance type. And here you can see the different instance type like nano, micro, small, medium, large, etc. In case of micro instance, number of CPU are 1 and memory is 1 GB, and instance storage is EBS only, and network performance will be low to moderate, and it is supporting IPv6. And if you take some other instance like X large, then number of CPU are 4 and memory is 16 GB, and internal storage is EBS only, and network performance is moderate. So like that, there are different instance types are there, and based on your need, you can select the instance type. And in this example, we are using a free tier. So we have to use this micro instance because it is eligible for free. Instances are virtual servers that can run applications. Amazon EC2 provides wide selection of instance types optimized to fit different use cases. And here I have selected micro instance and click on next. Step 3 is configure the instance details. Here you can see lot of configurations like number of instances. Here by default it is 1. If you want to change 2, 3, you can do that. And one of the option is shutdown behavior. There are two options are there, stop and terminate. So once instance is stopped, we can bring it back. But in case of terminate, once it is terminated, then it is gone. We cannot bring it back. So here I have choose stop. Next one is enable termination protection. I am going to enable this one to protect against accidental termination. We can protect the instance from being accidentally terminated. Once it is enabled, you won't be able to terminate this instance via API or AWS management console until termination protection has been disabled. And if you want to configure any other options, you can do that. And click on next. Step 4 is add storage. By default, for micro instances, the storage capacity is 8 GB. And for free tier customer, we can increase the storage capacity up to 30 GB. And when the instance is terminated, this particular storage needs to be deleted or not is decided by this checkbox. So I have unchecked this checkbox so that by accidentally, if I terminate, this storage won't be deleted. Click on next. Step 5 is add tax, and click on this. And here we have to give the name of the instance. So I'm going to give Spring Boot User Web Service. Click on next. Step 6 is configure security group. Security group is a set of firewall rules that control the traffic for your instance. And in this page, you can add rules to allow specific traffic to reach your instance. For example, if you want to set up a web server and allow internet traffic to reach your instance, what we have to do is we have to add rules that allow unrestricted access to the HTTP and HTTPS ports. Here you can see the type. Type is nothing but the protocol to open to network traffic. And in case of Linux instance, we have to use SSH. In case of Windows instance, we have to use RDP. And HTTP and HTTPS allow internet traffic to reach your instances. And we can also manually enter custom port or port ranges. And here I have selected SSH. Protocol is TCP. Port range is 22, and source we can give custom or anywhere or my IP. Anywhere meaning from any IP address, this instance can be accessed. I selected that. Then I am adding one more rule, HTTP, select anywhere, HTTPS, select anywhere. Then we are going to use Tomcat. Tomcat is going to use the port number 8080. So I have added a custom TCP rule and port number I am going to give 8080. Click on anywhere, then click on review and launch. Step 7 is review the instance launch, and here you can check all the changes and the configuration you have chosen, like AMI details, instance type, security groups, instance details, storage details, tags, and if you want to edit, then click on edit related to the particular section. Click on edit storage, and if you want to change anything, you can change it. Then click on review and launch. So once you finalized all changes are fine, then click on launch. And here we have to create a new key value pair, so that using that we can connect from outside computer to this particular instance. And here we have to provide a key pair name. I'm going to give a user API. Click on download key pair. Then click on launch instances. And here you can see your instances are launching. Click on this. Click on EC2. And here click on instances. Here you can see there are two instances are there, and this I have created for my learning purpose, and this one we have just launched. And here you can see the Spring Boot user web service instance, it is just running and it is initializing now. After some point of time, it will be available. And if you see, I have selected this one. And here you can see the public DNS name, and here you can see the public IPv4 address, and using this IPv4 address or public DNS name, we can connect to this particular instance. That we will see next. Click on refresh, and here you can see the status check has been done, and this particular instance is ready to use. and the details here you can see. Security, networking, storage, now this particular Spring Boot user web service instance is running, and here you can see options like stop instance, reboot instance, and terminate instance. And when you click on stop instance, the instance will be stopped. And suppose you don't want to use this instance for a week, you can stop this instance. And after that, if you want to start this instance again, you can start the instance and bring it back. And suppose you want to reboot the instance, click on this option and click on terminate instance, the instance will be removed and you cannot bring back. And I'm going to click on stop instance. Click on stop. So it is stopping now. After some point of time, the instance will be stopped. And suppose if you are not using this particular instance for a week, then Amazon won't charge amount for the particular period, because you are not using that instance for a week or 2 weeks. Your instance are stopped. Now you can see the instance is stopped. Next we will see how to connect this particular instance from outside machine. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.